welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Dr. Jack Regan. He is the CEO of LexaGene. And Jack is joining us from the floor of a convention. Jack, you're at the WVC convention. So you're in Las Vegas. Tell me a little bit about this convention. This is a big one.
Yeah, no, we're in Las Vegas. It's awesome. I mean, we're so excited to be back for in-person conferences. Obviously, we've had the pandemic in the past. All the conferences were shut down. Finally, conferences are resuming, even in the pandemic. This is very, very well attended, so we're very excited.
Yeah, tell us the type of people who are attending this conference. Who are you talking to?
So we have veterinarians, also the techs that assist veterinarians, you know, practice managers, and also all of the big strategics that are in animal health are here as well, which is just fantastic.
So what's your message to them? You obviously got the MiQLab beside you. So what's the message you're bringing to them about this technology?
So us, it's all about introducing the concept of in-clinic PCR. People have heard about PCR through COVID. So they have no idea that it's now available in the veterinary space. We have a lot of veterinarians swinging by saying, how cool is it that we can actually do PCR inside the clinic? So we've had tremendous traffic to the booth. We've had over 200 people swing by expressing interest in the MiQLab. So it's really been fantastic to see the enthusiasm that we're seeing from veterinarians.
Jack, what type of questions are they asking you?
So it all depends. I mean, so there are a lot of small animal veterinarians here, and they're asking, okay, can't do this, can't do that. A lot of them ask for additional menu options. This is one of the things that we really need to hear. You know, we just had a veterinarian swing by, and she's interested in doing respiratory pathogen detection in both small and large animals. She works with cows. She's up in Montana. They are interested in a virus called EBV virus, you know, salmonella and others that are already in our panel. So what we do is we take this information back. We're already developing a respiratory panel in collaboration with Ethos. Getting that voice of customer for future panels is extremely valuable to us. But fundamentally, they're excited about our current offering and what we can do to help change their practice.
Jack, I'm wondering, are you getting some saying, look, we do it in the lab already. We've got this. We're doing it this way. We've done it this way for 100 years. When someone says that to you, what do you do to say, look, if you want to be better at diagnosing these conditions, this is the technology that will take you to the next level. Is that sort of, I don't want to say argument, but is that the pitch point to them?
Well, one of our big messages is this theme of antimicrobial stewardship. Right now, if you look at the trends across human and animal health, the amount of resistance that is cropping up is really, really startling. We have to get away from the concept of prescribe first and only address complications if they arise. What we need to now change is the idea of saying, okay, diagnose first, understand the microbe you're dealing with, prescribe only what is necessary, no more or no less. There is a push right now across all veterinary medicine to start having better stewardship of our antibiotics. So these antibiotics are useful in 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. If you look at projections from the CDC, they're projecting that if we don't start changing our practice, there's going to be over 10 million people every year dying from antimicrobial resistance. To put that in context, if you look at the year 2020 with COVID, it's been a horrible year with the coronavirus pandemic, but worldwide, just over 3 million people died. Now, multiply that by 3 every single year, that's what might happen if we do not get a better handle of our antimicrobial stewardship. So veterinarians hear this story, they're excited that they finally now have a tool available to them in the clinic to help them do informed patient management decisions, which really will, we believe, be the wave of veterinary diagnostics moving forward.
And in fact, that message you're talking about there, Jack, you're leading a session with that as well. You're really hammering that home to all the veterinarians that you're coming in contact with, eh?
I am. This afternoon, I'm hosting a learning session at a talking station over here, over my right-hand shoulder. We're advertising that. We're expecting a full attendance where veterinarians get to learn about antimicrobial resistance. Often, they're so involved in the microcosm of their animal that they're seeing today, they often don't think about the consequences of their actions. And we're here to really educate and provide them the knowledge that they need to recognize that there are tools now available, which were not available last year, to them and their practice to help them do their job better.
Now, I know you're at booth 1558, but folks that may not be in Las Vegas, you are going to be at some other conferences as well, or at least the company will be.
We will. So this is a huge month for us. We're attending 3 veterinary conferences. Here we are in Vegas. Great, great conference. Next week, we will be in Nashville, Tennessee at IVEX. IVEX specializes in attracting emergency and critical care veterinarians. That's really, really our sweet spot. So even though this has been a fantastic conference for us, where a lot of veterinarians are expressing interest, we expect next week to even be better. And then at the end of the month, we are going to the Southwest Veterinary Symposium down in San Antonio, Texas to wrap up the month. It's gonna be just a fantastic month where we finally have the opportunity to get in front of veterinarians, have them demo the system. We have a very short demo to go through to teach them how easy it is to use, because many veterinarians are all scared of PCR. They think, okay, it only happens in the reference lab. They can't do it themselves. They're blown away with how easy it is to use once we show them.
Yeah. If you want more details, of course, you can go to your website, lexagene.com as well. Jack, thank you so much for taking the time. I know there's people waiting to talk to you, but we appreciate you giving us some of yours to talk to you about the excitement that's going on in Las Vegas. So great to see you again. Thanks very much.
Steve, always a pleasure. Thanks so much. Take care.
All right. There's Dr. Jack Regan. He is the CEO of LexaGene, live from Las Vegas.